with the practice of meditation, when you start going deeper and deeper into your own self, one point comes when you start experiencing abiding joy for no reason at all. You become joyous and you cannot assign any reason for the same. Such a joy is a real miracle, because that joy cannot be disturbed and cannot be destroyed, because that is not arising out of any cause. If your joy has arisen out of some achievement or success, that joy is bound to disappear when there is no success or when you lose to achieve the desired thing. But this joy, which is coming as a byproduct of meditation, is without any reason. And experiencing this joyous dimension of your being is just coming nearer to Buddhahood. Secondly, you will start feeling such a tremendous love arising within you, which you have never before experienced in your life. This love is the byproduct of meditation. In fact, if your meditation is in the right way, it gives rise to unconditional love in your life. And if your love is in the right way, it gives rise to authentic meditativeness inside you. And I want to tell you, true love is one which is born out of meditation, not out of the mind. You will wonder to know that all the love that we humans in general experience is the love which is born out of mind. And that is why this love fails to provide you the experiences of true love. It is something entirely different from real love. Millions of couples around the world are living as if they are in love, and they are trying to find happiness, thrill and romance out of that false love. And that is why there is continuous fighting, frustration and disappointment. They can never receive glimpses of true love. Their love has arisen out of the minds. Therefore, it cannot give the glimpses of the eternal. So my advice is, first go into meditation, and then love will grow spontaneously within you. That love which will be growing out of no mind, out of no time, that will give you the glimpse of unconditional love. It will not be directed to someone in particular. It will be directed towards all. And this love will not be a relationship, but it will be the state of being. Now you will not be loving. You will become just love itself. And this love will be the fragrance of your being. And it is the same love which had been the experience of Mahavir, Buddha, Krishna and Christ. And this love will not be asking for something in return, but it will be ready only to give, for the sheer joy of giving. Ultimately, coupled with meditation, the same joy becomes compassion. The third most significant byproduct of meditation is growth in intelligence. Generally, the growth of intelligence stops at the age of 14. With the deeper and deeper practice of meditation, immense intelligence is released. Intelligence simply means the ability to respond. An intelligent person always responds according to the need of the moment, according to the need of the situation. But a stupid person responds according to the ready-made answers given by the teachers, the traditions, and the scriptures. Intelligence can be discovered only by meditation, because meditation destroys all the prisons of the mind. Once a person takes a leap out of the mind with the practice of meditation, then it becomes difficult for him to remain conditioned by the practices of the society and the impositions made by the traditions. At this stage, it becomes impossible to remain confined to the prisons of Hinduism, Sikhism, Christianity, and Islam. All the communal and orthodox barriers are broken. An unconditioned soul is born, and this intelligence becomes identified with the infinite intelligence of the universe. And the experience of oneness with the infinite intelligence of the universe is the essence of all spirituality on this earth. The fourth miracle is that a sincere meditator becomes capable of celebrating his own aloneness without any dependence on anybody else or any situation as such. An inward journey is a journey towards absolute aloneness. You cannot take anybody else with you there. And when this aloneness is experienced, this becomes a synonym of bliss or godliness. Another point is also very significant. Meditation is nothing but a powerful device to make you aware of your own real self, which you already possess since your birth. But the unfortunate fact is that people are never aware of their own real self. With the practice of meditation, when you become aware of your real self for the first time, only then individuality is born within you. Now you no more remain part of the mob psychology. Now you do not follow the beaten track. You have your own understanding, your own approach, and your own specific sensibility to absorb things in a new way, which is not conditioned at all by the people around, by the traditions around, or by any other influences around you. Now you cannot be dominated or guided by the society, because society teaches you personality. The word personality comes from the word persona, which means a mask. But as an individual, you need no mask. You become thine your own self. I find that almost everybody is in a wrong place. A person who could be tremendously successful doctor is working as a painter, and vice versa too. And that is why everybody is suffering and everybody is leading a miserable life. Nobody is being directed by his own intuition. Meditation helps you grow your own intuition and to act according to your own inner moves. Meditation helps you grow your own intuitive faculty, which makes you clear as to what is useful for your inner fulfillment, and then you start doing accordingly. Every single individual is unique, and to seek, search, and find your own uniqueness is a great thrill and great adventure. Meditation is that powerful device which brings your uniqueness to you. Sixthly, only a true meditator can experience true silence. In fact, experience of true silence happens only after the flowering of meditation. Generally, silence is understood something to be negative, as absence of sound or a state of noiselessness. However, real silence is quite positive. It is prevailing within everybody. But we have no experience of that prevailing true silence within us, that true silence with which we are all born with. We remain deprived of the silence merely because we are overfilled with so much of noise within, and meditation is the only way through which we can be free of all the noise which is arising within, and thereby we can come in touch with the true silence prevailing within us. An unique soundless music is prevailing within us, and that is the state of our being. It is only through meditation that we can experience the center of the cyclone that is our being, the same soundless music which has been termed as Omkar by all the enlightened masters of the earth. Finally, meditation makes us highly sensitive and develop a sense of great belonging to the whole world. A sincere meditator starts experiencing the whole universe as a part and heart of his own being. And vice versa too, he starts feeling himself as a part and heart of this universe. And that is what the real situation stands to be. If you look closely, you will find that the whole universe is interdependent. The trees are producing fruits and flowers, but they are not eating the fruits themselves. They are doing it for you. The rivers are flowing with deep waters, but the rivers are not drinking their own water. They are carrying the water for you. The clouds are raining for you. The sun is rising and generating life for you. You are breathing out carbon dioxide for the trees. Trees are breathing out oxygen for you. What a beautiful interdependence. If this does not happen, both of you will disappear. But this state of oneness is experienced very deeply as a byproduct of meditation. Ultimately, this sensitivity will create new relationships with you, your relationships with the stars, with the sky, with the mountains, with the rivers, and with each and every aspect of the nature and the world. Indeed, you will experience a great miracle.